Hi, welcome to the Quicker Sim CFD Toolbox for MATLAB tutorial number 5. This tutorial is devoted to boundary layer meshing. That's a special function that's available in the full version of our Quicker Sim CFD Toolbox. Boundary layers are very important in fluid dynamics, as many key flow features happen over there. For instance, the drag generated on surfaces that's obtained in the fluid simulations strongly depends on the exact resolution of the flow in the vicinity of the wall. In principle, you should be generating computational mesh that already contains boundary layers in the mesh generator that you use. But if you want just to generate a simple mesh, you can still use some built-in functions that are in our toolbox. So, we'll discuss two cases. The first case is the one that you already know. That's the circular cylinder. Let's just have a look at that. And obviously the flow would pass around the cylinder. And what we will want to do, we will want to generate the boundary layer here at the solid walls. So what we do is we use a special structure that's called layer, and we have to define a few parameters of this structure. That's the height of the first element, the growth factor, that is the ratio of consecutive elements, like in geometric series, and the number of layers that we want to extrude. After that, we just have to define which wall IDs should be extruded, extrude the layers. Notice that we have to create at this moment a new version of variables PET as our mesh gets modified, and we have a look at the new mesh. Let's give it a try, and now you can see the difference as there is the zone of boundary layers created. Since our tool uses only triangular mesh, the boundary layer consists of triangles. So this is actually the first layer, this is the second layer, and this is the third layer. Anyway, this is the process of the boundary layer creation for the cylindrical case. The second case refers to the urban mesh that will be actually used in the tutorial number 9. Let's just have a look at how it looks without the boundary layer. So those are basically two square obstacles along the flow from left to the right. And since we'll be simulating complex turbulent flow, we will have to have really good resolution at the solid walls on the bottom. We will also show you some extra features as the Laplace smoothing of the boundary layer mesh. Okay, so definitely we have to define the boundary layers from zones 18 till 23. So that's what's being done in wall IDs. We prescribe new layer of height 0.02, again the same growth ratio, and again three layers. So just let's have a look at the basic mesh once again. Yes, there it goes. And let's play with the boundary layer extrusion. There it goes. So, yeah, the one thing that looks a little bit not according to the best practice is the fact that this boundary layer gets squeezed when we get closer to the corners. This can be fixed to some extent when we use extra parameters for our function extrude layers 2D. You can always refer to the tutorial to check if any more complex function contains some extra options. There are also two additional options available. That's called smooth steps and smooth alpha. Basically, that means that we apply extra smoothing for our mesh, and smooth alpha is the factor and smooth step is the number of smoothing iterations that are being performed. By default, when the mesh is generated, we use 10 smoothing steps, hence smooth alpha is equal to 0.9. So let's check out how it looks after different factors are used. So we decrease the number of smooth steps to 0.3 and smoothing to 0.8. Let's redo thing to make sure that memory is not corrupted. And that's still what we get in the vicinity of corners. Yeah, so actually that's even worse because we used 10 by default and now it dropped down to 3. But maybe we can still fix something. So yeah, let's use 50 smoothing steps and yet the same alpha. Let's have a look. Okay, so yeah, now it seems to be much better. This collapse of the boundary layer in the corner is not that strong anymore. Yeah, here it looks really nice. Obviously it collapses a little bit, it's pretty simplified function at this moment, but yeah, that's the tool that you should definitely be using to improving your boundary layers. You could also actually use that for improving your mesh in general. Okay, so this is the thing that we wanted to show you in this tutorial. We hope that you find it useful. Boundary layer generation is really necessary in many kinds of flows. And if you like that, please subscribe, drop us a comment, and check out other tutorials of QuickerSim CFD Toolbox for MATLAB. See you next time.